Good morning, guys. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. Yeah, the Walker Lane seismic zone has really been active today. 43 earthquakes within the last 24 hours. Over here, we got Bishop. We got Owens Valley. Let me show you what I've drawn out in Google Earth. I only put down a couple of the earthquakes, some of the larger ones. A magnitude 3.9, I think, was the largest. Back in 1986, this is what's called the White Mountain Fault. There was a magnitude 6.2. I believe two people were killed. Lots of money and damage. And you can see we got an area of agriculture. Ever since my Google Maps got wiped out, I've had to add things as earthquakes come in. So I drew out this fault. This fault, White Mountain, it goes, you know, it's part of the Walker Lane fault system. And you can see the direction that this side, the east side of this fault system, it's, let's see, how wide? 1,000 meters wide and about 500 kilometers long. Or it could have been 1,000 miles wide, I don't know. That seems a little extreme, so I just figured it was meters. It also says here that it is a right lateral shear zone, and it goes across the southern Walker Lane. Let me show you what it means by right lateral shear zone. USGS has got a video showing this. Let me start it over so you can see here. We got left lateral. Okay, there's the left lateral, shows you how the fault moves, and then we got the right lateral strike slip. I hope that helps. Oh, actually, it's IRIS, not USGS. So we have other faults that this area runs into. We got the Garlock Fault, which is down over here. This other one that I drew out, that's the Kern Valley fault system, but more than likely, yeah, you can't hold me to this, but the pressure and the fault's going to go down here towards the Garlock Fault. We have a twisting in this area, and this part is moving kind of northwest a little bit. So I was curious on how deep these earthquakes were. Yeah, see all the new ones here? Yeah, we got two there, one there, and another one there, moving towards the south. Anyways, we got 4.6 miles. This would be the depth of sea level, 00. 4.2 miles below sea level. 9.2 miles. I think the biggest one could have been this magnitude 3.9. Let's double check here. Yeah, quite a few threes. We got two 3.3s there. That one was 3.9 miles. This one was shallower, 1.9. Let's see. Come down. There's been, okay, we got a 3.8. That was shallow. Let me close this out. There's been a total so far, let's see if it's changed, 44 earthquakes in the last 24 hours. I believe it only started today. We'll go to 7 days. Yeah, this all started just today. 57, but see, they got earthquakes over here to the east. I have talked about how as the Earth's magnetic field weakens, we're going to be seeing an increase in earthquakes, how the plates are moving because of that. And this whole area is slowly moving, the North America plate, moving southwest. The walker lane takes up about 25% of all the stress of the movement, whereas the San Andreas Fault, which is over here, you guys all know where that's at, that takes up 75% of the stress of the plate movement. So having so many threes, yeah, there very possibly could be a larger one coming. People just need to be prepared. You should have things bolted to the walls. Make sure you don't have anything above where you may sit during the day or sleep at night. Keep a pair of shoes next to your bed. I tell people, if you're sleeping and there's a large earthquake, get on the floor next to the bed, especially for those that are in apartment buildings. But you should have medical supplies and food and water and documentation. Be prepared. Have some cash on hand in case the ATM machines aren't working. Things like that. Anyways, someone's been feeling this earthquake or earthquakes. I'll show you here. One person reported that they felt this 3.3, and let's look at the location if they have it. Nope, they don't have who felt it. Someone's been reporting they've been feeling these earthquakes. Anyways, that's all I have for you right now. Any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. Always be prepared for any type of disaster. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.